सो हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम बैक टू द लास्ट एपिसोड ऑफ माय न्यूकासल करियर मोड सीरीज एंड यस व्हाट अ सीजन वी हैड हियर एंड एज यू गाइस नो वी आर नाउ इन द सेमीफाइनल्स ऑफ द चैंपियंस लीग एंड वी आर फेसिंग मैनचेस्टर सिटी. सो दिस विल बी वन इंटरेस्टिंग फिक्स्चर हियर गाइस, द सेमीफाइनल अगेंस्ट सिटी. वी हैव आवर राइवल्स हियर, वी आर गोना फेस देम एंड आई विल बी होपिंग टू बीट देम, बट इट विल बी रियली डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज वी आर प्लेइंग away from home in the first leg, and but the second leg will be interesting because it's at our home. So even if we are losing in the semi-finals in the first leg, we still have got some time to recover from the loss in the second leg, but I'll be hoping to win as always. We just hoping for a win here, and if we win this against Manchester City with a big margin, it will be really difficult for them to cover up in the next leg. So we'll be hoping to beat them by a margin of 2-0 or 1-0, but let's just hope for a win here. We don't care about the margin. But the first goal here has come for Newcastle United, Wendell, and Madison heads it. And what a goal, what a header from James Madison. Newcastle United have now taken the lead against Manchester City. And this was a lovely header from Madison. Just heads it over Ederson. And in this episode, I'm just gonna show you guys the only the goals part of this in this episode, because all the matches, because the episode will be a bit lengthy this time. So I'm just gonna edit the most important goals in this episode, except the UEFA Champions League final obviously. But now another goal here has come. It's for Manchester City once. It's for Newcastle United once again here. Madison with a through ball to Wendell. 1-on-1 against the keeper, makes a mistake for the first time, then takes a shot, Ederson makes a fine save, the ball falls for Malen, who scores the goal. And yes, Newcastle United has scored here against City as well. And the second goal has come here. We have taken a 2-goal lead away from home, just 2 away goals. Just think what it means for the players of Newcastle United here. It will be really interesting the next match as well, because it will be against City only in the Champions League second leg. But now another goal has come. Once again, Wendell scoring this time. And we just have scored 3 goals here and just being the dominant side in this game, in the first leg against City. And this was a lovely goal from Wendell. 1-on-1 against the keeper. This time did not make a mistake like the second goal. And he just scores up. Third goal here, and we have a tremendous lead against Manchester City. And now we are just hoping for a final whistle here, which has come, and we have won it against City. But you guys know 3-0 lead is still not enough, because there have been matches in the history in the Champions League that even 3 or 4 goal leads have been turned around. But it will be difficult for Manchester City here, but they have the players. They have the best players in the world, so they can do that. Here, the man of the match is James Maddison once again. He has been in brilliant form in the Champions League. Wendell, 8.6 are the highlights of the player ratings in this game. But what a match we had here. Looking at the match facts, all dominated by Newcastle United. They have been the dominant side in the first leg. But now just I'm going to simulate the game against Manchester City, because one game, because the next 3 games are against Manchester City only. The same side facing them 3 times. It's just really boring, because so I'm just gonna simulate the game against them in the Premier League so that I face them in the Champions League second leg. And that's what I'm hoping for. Then the game against Cardiff City and Everton will be simulated as well. And then I'll be showing you guys the clip of the Wolves game and the Champions League final if we reach them. If we reach the final, as always, obviously. But now I'm just gonna simulate the game against Manchester City, and we'll be hoping to win it here. But obviously, I'm just gonna simulate, so we cannot expect to win it easily. But a draw is also fair enough, because we have the lead against Liverpool in the title race. So yeah, just I'm gonna simulate the game. And Alexandro has been injured in the game. Let's hope it's not anything serious. But we have drawn against Manchester City away from home. A fair enough result, I can say. and I just hope for not losing the game. We did not lose, and the Alexandros injury, it's nothing serious. He is just out for 7 days, which is just what I was hoping for. I'm just happy here. So Bukayo Saka will be taking his place in the game against City in the Champions League second leg, which I'm just gonna record here. But again, I'm just gonna show you guys the goals in this game as well, as it's a long episode. But the game against Manchester City, this one will be really tough, guys. It's the semi-final second leg. We have the advantage. We have a massive advantage. Let's just hope that the defense does not make mistakes. But in the 56th minute, there has been a goal. It's for Manchester City. Maignan makes a mistake. Pareo plays it to Sterling, and a clear post for him to score. It was just a mistake from my defense there. I should not have overcommitted my keeper. I just did that, and the keeper was nowhere to be seen, and it was an open goal. Wan-Bissaka should be covering the post, but he goes somewhere else. And Manchester City have scored their first goal, but they still have two more goals to come back. But they are looking to score the second goal as well, which has been actually scored here by Raheem Sterling, who takes a shot from the mid region of the ground, and he just takes a shot from the midfield. And what a goal, I can say. I need to appreciate this man for his efforts. A curled effort straight into the bottom right corner, and the keeper had no chance. And looking like Manchester City need just a goal here to come back, but I don't think it's gonna come here, because ref has view for the end of the game. A close game in the ending minutes. But finally, the Newcastle fans and the manager will be happy, because they have won it. Pep Guardiola, obviously he'll be disappointed for the result, but obviously his team did not play well at home. They had the home advantage in the first leg. They could not just keep that record at their home, and they just lost it against, and that loss has just caused them here a victory, a spot into the finals. And Newcastle fans really will be praising everywhere about the players. They'll be raving about them because they are in the Champions League final, and they will be facing Atletico Madrid, who have just won it against Dortmund. It's a turnaround, actually. They were 2-goal down, but they just won it against Dortmund in the second leg. And we'll be facing Atletico Madrid in the semi-finals. That will be interesting. In the final, sorry. And that will be one interesting fixture, guys. Now, I'm just looking at the upcoming fixtures here. And so, yeah, the game against Cardiff City and Everton, as I told you guys, I'm gonna simulate the game. But as you see here, the final against UEFA against Atletico Madrid in the Champions League, it will be really an interesting fixture there, guys. But the game now, I'm just gonna simulate the games against Cardiff City and Everton. I'll be recording the game against Wolves. So now, just let's simulate the game against Cardiff City here. And yeah, we just won against them in the away fixture, and we won it against them by a comfortable margin. So I'm just gonna simulate the game. And the results are here. Steven Bergwijn scores a brace. Ricky Puig scores the second goal. And just that's the fine result I was hoping for. Finest result I was hoping for. And the game against Everton as well, I'm just gonna simulate, because I'm just wanting to win the title here. I'm just need to do it really quickly. So yeah, the game against Everton as well is being simulated here. It's at home, so we have the advantage to beat them. And which we do. Steven Bergwijn, yet another brace for him, and Wan-Bissaka on the score sheet as well. We certainly could not keep the clean sheet, but that's just fine with me, because we are just gonna lift the trophy in this game here, guys. We have just already dethroned Liverpool from the top spot. We are currently at the top, and this final fixture will be interesting against Wolves, because if you guys remember, the first game of the season was against Wolves as well, and now the last game, it's against Wolves only. And let's just hope for a win here. Let's just hope to end the season in the Premier League with a win. And yes, you see, we are away from home. It will be really interesting to lift the trophy away from home, guys, in in front of the away supporters. But now the first goal has come here. Sandro Tonali. What a goal from Sandro Tonali. Oh my word, the captain. What a goal from him. And really, what a goal from him, man. I just need to take another look on the goal. But they are dancing here, the players. And they deserve to dance here because they know they have won the Premier League. And it's just fair enough to dance in front of the opponents just to annoy them. But now, what a goal from Sandro Tonali, man. What a goal. What a curled effort. We just want to see this goal over and over again. What a finish, man. What a finish. One of the best goals I have scored in the season. And it has come from our captain, Sandro Tonali. We just score the first goal here. And the second goal is coming here now. In the second half, Vinicius Jr. plays it to Sandro Tonali, who takes the shot. Oh my word, he is just delivering some best goals here, Sandro Tonali. And what a goal once again from him. I just cannot believe what is happening here, guys. The first goal in a similar fashion from the captain, and the second goal as well. Just some fabulous goal he is scoring here. And this time, even from a longer range, hitting it on the first time. What an absolutely brilliant goal from him. Oh, I'm just so happy from this man, really. A brace for him. The captain is delivering in the semi-finals. In the final game of the season, sorry. And now another goal has been coming here. This time from Wendell. One-on-one against the keeper. A simple goal from our team. And the team has just destroyed Wolves here. But really, one man who has to be appreciated is Sandro Tonali, man. He will be the player of the match, I can say. And he is going off. Ricky Puig will be coming on for him. But we don't care whoever lifts the trophy, even if it's not Sandro Tonali. He is low on stamina, so I'm going to substitute him. He is going off, but he'll be going off with some appraisals from his teammates as well as the manager. And now the moment we were all waiting for has finally arrived. Newcastle United have won the Premier League title. Just 9 months or so, the players were working on so hard just to lift that trophy. And they have certainly done that. And really, the manager, the players will be the happiest right now. Obviously, the fans as well. You cannot just underestimate them. You just cannot forget them. So now, Ricky Puig is lifting the Premier League title. We don't care whoever lifts the title, man. We just don't care because we have won it. The Premier League title is ours. And now, let's share the glory with the fans here. They deserve it. And I just skipped the celebrations by mistakenly, but we don't care because we have won the Premier League title. And the next game, it's against Atletico Madrid in the finals of the Champions League at the Stadia Olympiaco, and we will be winning the Champions League. I'll just be hoping to win it. It won't be easy, and just let's go for the game here. And looking at the players here for Atletico Madrid starting lineup, we see Alvaro Morata, Paul Pogba as well. I just thought that he would be signing for Real Madrid, who has been currently linked with Real Madrid. But eventually he has signed for Atletico Madrid, which means he'll be a dominant force in this game. And just, I don't care whoever the players are. We are at the Stadio Olimpico and we are ready for the finals of the UEFA Champions League. And the first chance here, it's for Newcastle United. And now Wendell, he plays it to Malen, and he scores our first goal in the Champions League. And Malen has been, this will be one of the memorable goals he has ever scored in his career, a goal in the Champions League final. And just the perfect goal, 1-1 against the keeper, Wendell with the assist. So let's have a look at another look on the goal. And that was some great interplay between the players. And Malen scores our first goal in the final. We have just taken the lead, but it's just a slight advantage. We know that Atletico Madrid have a brilliant attack. We just saw them, Joao Felix as well in the team, so they can score. Just we cannot just sit back and relax here at the moment. And now the half time, it's coming to a close, but a chance here. Madison turns, takes a shot, and hits the post. Oh my word, that would have been a sick goal had it gone in. But the chance is over. What an effort from James Maddison. But we could not score. But we don't care, because we have a lead here. It's a slender lead. It's a slight lead. We just cannot sit back and relax here. We know they will be coming hard. Diego Simeone will be doing something here. He won't just sit back here. And now an attack. It's for Atletico Madrid. Partey plays it to Icardi. Almost the first goal for Atletico Madrid in the final. Almost the equalizer they scored. And Mauro Icardi should be doing better than that. He just misses the target from such a close range as well. He should be doing better than that. But now another attack here for Atletico Madrid. Joao Felix crosses towards the center. Correa. Thomas Partey takes the shot and scores the equalizer in the 88th minute here. And a late equalizer we have conceded. And I by mistakenly quick substituted our captain. I just don't want Ricky Puig once again lifting the Champions League trophy this time. I won't be substituting Sandro Tonali here. But now, this was a great goal from Thomas Partey, the Ghana international player, and he has scored. He was linked to Arsenal this season as a move in the summer, but he hasn't signed yet. But now an attack. It's for our team. It has been squandered there by Atletico Madrid. And we just could not score a late goal here. We are just hoping a cross played in, but defended well by Atletico. And we know that the extra time will be coming here as the scoreline is drawn. But brilliant football from both the sides here in the final. They are looking really potentially brilliant teams here. And we just haven't substituted any player in this game as well. But if we do not score, I'll just be bringing on some players. But now a free kick taken quickly by a player. And now Malen. Vinicius Jr., what a goal from him in the Champions League final. And what a goal from Vinicius Jr. And the Volta celebration. But what a goal from Vinicius Jr. here. The most important goal he has scored ever in his career, I can say. But what a goal from Vinicius Jr. I guess this will be putting a lots and lots of pressure on Atletico. But what a goal. What a curled effort from Vinicius Jr. And the Brazilian scores here for his side in the 100th minute. And Wendell will be going off. And Elmas will be coming on for him. But now a corner for our team. Corner played in by Steven Bergwijn, but defended well by Atletico. And this comes to the end of the first half in the extra time. And we just have a goal lead here. And now, we just got three more substitutes left here. And I'll be making all of them right now. Bukayo Saka, Patson Daka, and Reece James will be coming on here. Okay, just let's bring on Reece James. He'll be playing in his right back position, Bukayo Saka in the left back position, and Patson Daka in the attack. Now I'll be just hoping to defend here in the second half of the extra time. Just 15 minutes to spare. We just want to lift that trophy. But now an attack. It has a chance. And if this goes for a goal, it's surely over for Atletico. Patson Daka. Lovely dribbling from him. And he scores. This is it, guys. We just have won the Champions League. It's for sure, man. We just have won it. And Patson Daka, what a goal from him. What a goal from him. The substitute. I just made the perfect substitute at the right time. And this has just rewarded us. And we just now are hoping for the final whistles. The fingers are crossed. But now, in the 128th minute, Atletico are attacking. And that's a foul from Ukiel. And that's a foul. Really, that's a foul. And no, sorry, it's Fikayo Tomori, and he gets the yellow card as well for that. Let's just have a closer look on that. So we got a penalty here, but And yes, obviously, they got a penalty. That was a horrific tackle inside the penalty box. Penalty taken by Icardi. And what a save from Maignan. Icardi is just playing really poor in this game. Could not score from anywhere. And just, we are just hoping. Time wasting here by our keeper. Clears the ball. And we love you, Newcastle United. We do. Is the song which the players will be singing, which the fans will be singing, and obviously what I am gonna sing here. We love you, Newcastle United. We do love you. They have just won it, and they have won the Premier League, they have won the Champions League, and they have won the Carabao Cup. That gives us a treble here. And I'm just gonna use the chant for Manchester United for them here. Glory, glory, Newcastle United. Yes, that's the thing I can say here. And now the photo with the Champions League trophy, a memorable one, this one. The players, the memories will be going on and on for them for like years and years here. But what an end to the season we had here in the Champions League final. We have won it against Atletico. What a turnaround in the extra time here. And just rereading the world news here, the news headlines, Madison, he is just celebrating with the trophy. But now let's have a look at the players' stats here in the season. And Ramsdale, Maignan keeping good clean sheets in the season. Alexandro did well, 21 clean sheets he has kept. Nordin Mukiel with the same stats here. Alexandro, 51 games he played, 21 clean sheets. Mukiel, 48 games, 21 clean sheets. And he has got an average of 7.3 out of 10, which is fair enough. Fikayo Tomori, 32 games, 33 games he played, 7.3 rating his as well. He just played well in the center back position. Now, William Saliba, 26 games he played really well. Aaron Wan-Bissaka, 7.3 his rating as well. Marcus Sensi, 50 games he played well. Reece James, 41 games, 7 his rating. Sandro Tonali, 50 games he played, 7.3. Our captain just delivered some best goals in this very episode. He has been the best captain, I can say. The best, one of the best players, one of the most underrated players in the series. Douglas Lewis, 25 games he played, 7.1 his average. Fair enough. He was just the regular rotational player for us. He came on as a sub. He played well. Bukayo Saka as well, a substitute. He played well as well. 7 is his rating out of 10. Fair enough. He has been a new acquisition. He played well. Ricky Puig, 24. And 5 goals and 3 assists for him this season. 7 his average. He was a great player as well. Eljif Elmas, and his appearance, 43 games he played, 5 goals, 8 assists, fair enough. Wendell, this man is one to watch here, 52 games he played, 11 goals, 7 assists, 7.4 his rating. One of the best players, one of the best players this season I have signed. James Maddison, 58 matches he played, 22 goals, 11 assists. What a stats we are seeing here for this lad. 7.6 is his rating. One of the best players for us this season. Vinicius Jr., the Brazilian whom we signed in the last season, in the seasons. And he has played 53 games, 12 goals and 9 assists. Fair enough, he could not just complete the season objective for him. We were just hoping for the golden boot with him, but we could not. Steven Bergwijn, he recently signed for us in the January transfer window as a replacement for Ferran Torres. 27 appearances, 11 goals and 5 assists. Fair enough. Brian Diaz, mostly used as a substitute. 28 appearances, 7 goals and 5 assists for him. Patson Daka, the recent acquisition. 24 games he played, and he played really well in the last 5 episodes, I can say. 9 goals, 6 assists. He also scored in the Champions League final. Donnel Malen, this man is the best player in the series. I am just gonna say that. 53 appearances, 35 goals, and 16 assists. how often do you see those stats? 8 out of 10 is his rating, but I'll give him 10 out of 10, guys. He has been the prolific striker for us this season. And yes, that was the player ratings, that was the stats for this season. And the season has come to an end. And what a season we had here. What a roller coaster season, what a brilliant season. We just hoped in the very first episode in the series that we are going to live the Champions League. We are going to live the UEFA Champions League as well. And the Premier League. And the Carabao Cup. And the Emirates FA Cup. Which we did. All of these 3-4 cups, we have just won it. We just won 4 cups this season. And yes, the next series will be coming up tomorrow itself. The new series. It will be Real Sociedad career mode. And yes, but until then, guys, really, thank you very much, guys, for watching my channel. Thanks for the support. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. But thank you very much, guys, for viewing my channel. And really, thank you.